So, you have a high VPD problem. Well done. Admitting it is the first step. Seriously, the preliminary question is, should we treat the causes of your VPD issue, or do we just try and alleviate the symptoms? The answer is, da-da-da-da, both. Really? Yes, both. Remember, high VPD means there's a big difference between the saturated vapor pressure inside the leaf and the air vapor pressure in your grow room. The high vapor pressure deficit is what's forcing your plants to uptake lots of water and solutes due to the resulting high transpirational demand on your plants. Let's dive straight into the example. Back in May, I erected a lot. I erected a Sun Hut Blackout 100 grow tent in my attic. The ambient relative humidity was low, hovering around 25%. Ouch! The air temperature was 26 degrees Celsius or about 79 degrees Fahrenheit. Here are some tomato cuttings looking happy in their deep water cloner. This is just a regular super sprouter aqua clone filled with a 50-50 mix of tap water and RO water adjusted to pH 6. Note that I didn't add any nutrients and I measured the leaf's temperature to be around 24 degrees Celsius or 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Using my trusty VPD calculator, I see that gives us a VPD of 2.14 kilopascals. Yikes! This is way over my suggested range for propagation and early vegetative growth, 0.4 to 0.8 kilopascals. So why are my cuttings even alive, let alone looking pretty healthy? Answer? Well, yes, the VPD is way too high. And yes, these cuttings would thank me for a humidity dome, but they're not exhibiting any symptoms of high VPD because they're just sucking up water with virtually no dissolved nutrients in there. As soon as I add nutrients to the equation by transplanting them into a rich soil-based potting mix, still feeding with water, then bam, look how sick they get. At this point, a novice grower might well point an accusatory finger at the potting mix and march angrily to his local hydro store demanding a refund. But there's nothing intrinsically wrong with the potting mix. It's my growing environment. Take a closer look at those leaves. Chlorosis. Necrotic spots. Just horrible! So what sequence of events has led to this situation? Think of high VPD as just the start of the story, not the epilogue. High VPD causes our freshly rooted cuttings to over-transpire as too much water is being sucked out of them by the dry air. This in turn forces our tender young plants to uptake lots of water from the potting mix. This water carries solutes or dissolved nutrients from the potting mix, and I'd wager that the preliminary culprit here is calcium, an immobile element that relies on transpiration to transport it through the plant. So, if transpiration rates are too high, guess what? Too much calcium is taken up. This, in turn, causes other nutrients to be locked out. Potassium, magnesium, manganese, and iron. Now we have what I will politely call a chain reaction. Iron and magnesium lockout means no more chlorophyll can be produced, hence the pale leaf color. Potassium and manganese deficiencies cause their own set of problems, including stomatal regulation. So what causes high VPD? Essentially, high temperatures and low humidity are two antagonists. Their effects can be exacerbated by too much air movement around the leaves, or radiant heat from grow lights being too close to the leaves, especially grow lights that emit a lot of infrared like HPS. Move your grow lights up, then dim them down or change to a light source lower in infrared like LED. Alternatively, consider switching to an air-cooled hood so you can safely dial down your garden's ventilation in an effort to guard some transpired moisture and elevated relative humidity. You could also add a humidifier, but I find that they don't work well in small grow tents. Better to humidify the room the grow tents are situated in. Use humidity domes to create a localized high humidity zone around your plants. Or if your plants are larger and in mid-flower, that is, too big to cover with a humidity dome, then you're going to have to keep the PK booster on the shelf, my friend, and reduce your nutrient concentration. Here's an example. If you're shooting for a maximum VPD of 1.6 kilopascals and you find yourself to be around 2.0, then you're 0.4 kilopascals too high. That's 25% over. Try to offset this by lowering the strength of your nutrient solution by at least the same percentage. So if you're feeding at 1,000 ppm, reduce to 750 ppm while you try to fix the causes of the high VPD. If your feeding schedule includes CalMag, try reducing that first, and like I said, forget about using any PK boosters until your high VPD pressures are resolved. Finally, greenhouse growers sometimes wet the greenhouse floor or crank up the evaporative cooling in an effort to alleviate high VPD. Similarly, try spraying the inner walls of your grow tent or trays of water on the floor to increase humidity. Okay, I'll cover dealing with low VPDs in a follow-up video soon. Take care, amigos, and don't forget to post any questions or comments down below. You know I love to hear from you. If you haven't yet subscribed, then please, for the love of newborn kittens, hit that big red button. Thanks for watching. This is Everest VPD OUT.